Hi, Kathy White, certified professional ergonomist. We are still in a pandemic. It's been over 18 months. And something that's been coming up a lot is well-being of individuals. With ergonomics, a lot of times we talk about physical well-being. We talk about the design of the workplace in order to be able to optimize comfort and in turn, productivity. But there are actually other aspects of ergonomics that are traditionally called psychosocial factors that have not been considered necessarily as part of the ergonomics equation. When I'm talking about psychosocial factors, I'm talking about aspects of our workplace that is really shaped by the culture of the environment you work in, the policies you have in your workplace, expectations that come from your leadership, and just the overall social attitude of your organization. Basically, what I'm talking about is looking at the demands of the work and the controls that are in place to help the worker meet those demands. A lot of times we look at those physical pieces, but what about stress that you can have from some of the societal pieces or cultural aspects of your organization? That's an important equation to consider with ergonomics and the potential of developing a musculoskeletal disorder. Ergonomics, we're talking about making sure that we're adapting work to the worker rather than forcing the worker to adjust to the task. That doesn't just apply to the physical environment, it applies to the social needs of the workers as well as these cultural aspects that we're talking about. Because if we're going to place psychosocial factors into this equation, we certainly have the potential to place too much demand on people, and that demand can exceed their ability to cope with them. That's a stress response. Some amount of stress is okay and actually healthy, but the problem is when we put too much stress on an individual, and I can give you a few examples to consider, then we can start to actually exacerbate and potentially increase the probability of developing a musculoskeletal disorder or even increasing the severity of a musculoskeletal disorder. So here's a few things you should be thinking about when you're evaluating the psychosocial environment in your workplace. And you can look at this for yourself or if you're in a position where you're evaluating others. You want to look at the demands of the job. And this goes beyond the physical environment. Is there pressure to complete tasks in a certain amount of time? Is there a certain pace of work that must be met? How many rest breaks are provided? What does the workload look like? Are there certain periods of time where there's more work than others? These would be examples of some of the job demands you want to look at because it can get very frustrating if you're not able to meet the demands for the task. And that can result in a variety of effects in the stress response. That can result in workers starting to do things like using medication to cope, which may have side effects, or if they wind up using substances in an uncontrolled manner to deal with that stress, that can lead to other issues as well. So we're really trying to think of the individual as a whole person here when we're talking about job demands. Another aspect to consider with the job is job control. Does the person feel like they're able to be involved in the decisions that are made in the organization? What level of influence are they able to have on the work itself and the outcomes of work? We talk a lot about trying to empower employees, but certainly if individuals are put in positions where they don't feel like they're able to do that, that can also lead to stress and potentially exacerbating pain again. Another aspect to consider is job satisfaction. It's usually preferable if you can provide variety in the tasks that people are conducting rather than having a monotonous activity. Providing opportunities for development can be helpful, giving people an opportunity to use their skills. So again, if people are in situations where there's lots of demands placed on them or they're in a monotonous type of activity, this can be very frustrating. If they can't keep up with work, they might feel like they need to skip breaks or put in additional time in order to meet the demands for the job. That reduces the amount of time for the body to be able to recover from the physical or mental efforts associated with the work. In addition, somebody might try to hurry up to complete their work and they might then take on more weight, let's say, than what they should be handling at any given time. So it's another example of an action that can take a toll on the body. Another thing you may want to consider is just overall support. What kind of social network is available within that team environment at work to help provide some emotional support for the worker. And that this is also an example of something that might come from family. So again, people get stressed out, they tend to tense up, they tense up their muscles, their body. This can also reduce some blood flow circulation and impact the body. I'm trying to kind of draw some parallels here for you so you can kind of understand these are some aspects to consider that are really important from a wellness perspective, but there's definitely a tie-in with ergonomics with all of these interventions that we're talking about. And traditionally, we do just focus on that physical work environment, trying to get the table at the right height, trying to get items within reach, trying to reduce weight of objects. But we need to understand some of these psychosocial factors are very multifactorial in nature, and having an integrated approach to be able to evaluate the workplace and the worker is going to really help us be a lot more impactful in terms of really being able to reduce musculoskeletal risk. So I encourage you, think about the physical environment, but also think about that social and mental, emotional support environment. All of that shapes company culture, and it really helps us on the road to supporting our workforce and reducing potential for stress and strain and sprain. Thanks for taking the time to listen.